శుక్లాంబరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వవిఘ్నోపశాంతయే రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేధసే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయ పతయే నమః. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీ ఆర్ నౌ ఇన్ దిస్ అయోధ్యకాండ. వీ వర్ జస్ట్ సీయింగ్ ది 28th సర్గ ఇన్ విచ్ రామ ఈస్ ట్రైంగ్ టు పర్సువేడ్ సీత టు స్టే బ్యాక్. Rama, we have seen that he has decided to go to the forest, and now he convinced, initially he convinced his mother Kausalya, now he has come to Sita, and then he is trying to convince Sita, but Sita is not being convinced. Sita says, I have to come with you. Kimidam bhashase Rama, what is it you are talking very light of me? I am supposed to come along with you when you have been ordered to go to the forest. Automatically, I am also ordered to go to the forest because I can't leave you, I have to be always with you. So that is what she says. And that is how the discussion was going on. Actually, what we see here is, so hitherto Valmiki has been portraying how Rama has been following dharma. Now in these 2-3 chapters he is showing how Sita in a similar way, she is also showing a very exemplary behavior, how she is following dharma in spite of all the troubles and all that. How she follows dharma, that is being portrayed here by Valmiki. So here in this 28th sarga, Rama again was trying to convince her. Sita mahakulinasi, you are born in a very noble family, and then dharmesha nirata sada, you are a person who knows all the dharma and all that, and forest dwelling is not so easy. Forest, and you are an abala, tvaya abale, this abala means you are a very feeble person, a weak person, and you will not be able to stand the rigors of all the forest life. And he says, bahu dosham hi kantaram, there are so many troubles, there are so many problems it is fraught with so many problems and so many difficulties, you see. And there are some forest wild animals in the forest, wild animals, and then mad elephants and things like that, and various water animals. If you step into the water, there can be crocodiles and all that. Sagraha saritascheiva, when you step into the water, there will be some streams, and in those streams there will be sagraha. Graha means a crocodile. Crocodiles can be there, and there are several other places where there are some thorns, bushes, and then without even water points in the forest. Nirapascha sudukhascha, nirapascha, where there is no water also. In the forest, you see, in some places there are certain water points. So there are several places where even the water points are very difficult. Very rarely you get a water point. So such places will be there, and you have to sleep on the grass somewhere. You have to sleep on the leaves. రాత్రిషు శ్రమఖిన్నేన తస్మాత్ దుఃఖతమో వనం. ఆల్ ది పీపుల్, ది ఫారెస్ట్ డ్వెల్లర్స్, ఆల్ త్రూ ద డే దే డూ లేబర్, అండ్ దెన్ అగైన్ ద నైట్ ఫాల్, వెన్ ద నైట్ ఫాల్స్ దెన్ దే జస్ట్ టేక్ సమ్ లీవ్స్, స్ప్రెడ్ అవుట్ ద లీవ్స్ ఆన్ ద గ్రౌండ్, అండ్ దెన్ దే స్లీప్ ఆన్ ద లీవ్స్. అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ దర్ ఫుడ్? దర్ ఫుడ్ ఈస్ ఫ్రూట్స్ ఫాలన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ట్రీస్. దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫుడ్. అండ్ నౌ వాల్మీకి ఈస్ సెయింగ్ దట్ ఈవెన్ వెన్ యూ గో టు ద ఫారెస్ట్, దెర్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ద డైలీ రొటీన్. In our culture, what we find is, a man's life has been so structured. Wherever you go, you are supposed to do your Sandhya Vandana, you are supposed to do this Pancha Mahayajna, what are called Pancha Mahayajnas. These are the things which are compulsory. You see, human activity has been very well analyzed in our system. Human activity means, after all, a human being, he has to do some action all through the day. And how to regulate the human activity, how to ensure that there is some social discipline. We have been seeing, I think earlier also I told you some time ago, that the karma or action has been divided into some 3 or 4 categories. One is a nitya karma. Nitya means one has to essentially do wherever you are. And next is kamya. Kamya karma means, okay, you are a person well settled in life. But in spite of that, you want some more prosperity. You want your son to get a good seat in some MD or something like that, or you want your daughter to get married. So you will do some other karma, you perform some vrata, you perform something like that. So that is what is called kamya karma. So kamya karma is not something which is mandatory. It is not something which is compulsory. Whereas nitya karma is something, wherever you are, it is something which is compulsory. Even if you are in a travel, even if you are on traveling somewhere, even then at the right time we are supposed to do the Sandhya Vandana. Even without water, Sandhya Vandana, maybe it may require some water and then pouring of water and then taking things like that, But if when there is nothing, you can as well do, you can just recite it wherever you are, do this Manasika Sandhya Vandana. And then even in the forest, we have to do, suppose there is a guest, you have to give food to the guest, that is what is called Atithi Yajna, Deva Yajna, you are supposed to say worship the deities, that is called Deva Yajna, then Pitru Yajna, Swadhyaya Yajna, these are all certain compulsory things which a person is supposed to do wherever he is. So that is how a human life, the activity of human life has been structured in our system. So he says, Devatanam Pitrunancha Kartavyam Vidhipurvakam. It has to be done. It is something vidhi. Vidhi means something which is prescribed. In Vedas, there are two words called vidhi and nisheda. Vidhi means something which has been prescribed. One has to do that. Nisheda means something which has been proscribed. Prescribed and proscribed means something which is prohibited. So that should not be done. And whatever has been prescribed has to be done. He says, Vidhipurvakam, this Deva Puja, Pitru Yajna, etc., these are the things which have to be done. Praptanam, Atithinancha, Nityashah, Pratipujanam. Whoever, suppose some guest, suppose you are dwelling in the forest, you are staying in a small hut, whatever it is. Some other hermit, some other sage, or somebody comes, you have to say, treat him well. You have to do this Atithi Satkaram, as we call it. So, all those things, they are again mandatory. So, all this he says, and you should also do puja to the deities, we have to gather flowers, upaharascha kartavya kusumai swayam ahrutaihi. So, we have to get some, say kusuma, kusuma means flowers, the flowers you have to fetch flowers from somewhere and then you have to get and then you have to do some puja to the deities. So, all these things, all are the duties, and then in addition to that there are, say wild animals and all such things. And again, there are always some violent winds, darkness, hunger, he says, Ativa Vatas Timiram, that is violent winds, and then Timiram is darkness, all this hunger and great fear, all these things, they will be there. And say all these wild animals again and again he is describing. And we have to lead such a very austere life, very, very ascetic type of life, tapas. In a very, very, it is just like a tapas. You have to lead a very, very austere life. And again, Sita, that is how this particular sarga, 28th sarga, closes. In 29 again, we are seeing the same continuation because 3 or 4 sargas, this discussion between Sita and Rama we see here. And again she says, she is pleading to him, you see all these troubles which you are talking about, they are not troubles. It is something which is, I am taking a fancy for them, I am fascinated by them. If I am seeing some wild elephants and wild animals and all that, I am fascinated, I want to see that. So that is how she says. So she says, Etvaya kirtita doshaha. What all have been described as dosha. Dosha means all these faults and then problems, etc. All those things. In fact, guna nityeva tanvidhi. In fact, they are all gunas. They are all attractions there. They are all attractions which are there in the wild life. And I want to see that thing. And when your love is there with me, when your love is for there behind me, behind them all, I can tolerate anything. And all the animals will run away from you. She says, all these animals, you see, adushtapurva rupatvat sarvete tava raghava. Seeing your very presence, seeing your very physics and seeing you, all the animals will also run away. And in fact, I was also told earlier that I have to follow you. You see, when my marriage was performed, my father himself said, chayeva anugata sada, she will follow you like a shadow. Chaya means a shadow. Like a shadow she will follow you. It was told earlier, Tvayacha saha gantavyam maya gurujanagnyaya. Gurujanagnya. Gurujanagnya means, I have already been commanded by all the elders that I have to follow you. So that is how, I can't leave you, I have to follow you. And when protected by you, even Indra cannot do any harm to me. She says, you see, nobody will be able to harm me. When I am protected by you, I am absolutely safe. And nobody can harm me. And he says, and she says, she continues to say, you have yourself told, till now, you have told them, you have been saying that patihina tu ya nari, a woman who is not following her husband, she cannot live. You have been saying that. This truth has been pointed out by you quite often. And how can you ask me to stay back? Not only that, Lakshanibhyo Dvijatibhya, she is now talking about what is called Samudrika Shastra. We have got one peculiar science called Samudrika Shastra. I do not know whether this particular Shastra is there in other parts of the world. Of course, palmistry is there in Western countries also. But Samudrika Shastra is for the entire, all the parts of the body, starting from not only hands, but feet, and then the formation of the skull, the formation of the nose, the formation of say the shoulders, the formation of the feet, everything, all things which are which are there in the human body, all these things are so meticulously observed, whether a person has hair on his body, whether a person is hairless. So all these things, it makes a very interesting reading. You can go to Google, you can do some Google search and see what is this Samudrika Shastra. If you see the original shlokas also, if you can get hold of it, they will be quite interesting. We can't say whether they are all accurate or not, but whatever it is, people have observed over a period of time. For example, they say kapati romahinascha, a person who is not having hair on his body, suppose the totally absolutely no hair, he will be a person who cannot be trusted. Kapati. Kapati means a sort of hypocritical person. Bahuroma tu bandhavak, somebody who has too many hair, etc. He can be trusted. He is a person who has lot many bondages. So, and also fingers, what is the size of the finger, what is the say length of the second finger, etc. All these things they describe. It is a sort of very interesting say subject. We cannot call it science, but it is some sort of empirical thing which has been observed over a period of time, and people have said, okay, if a person is like this, if he is having his fingers like this, his qualities will be like this. If his feet are like this, his quality will be like this. So, like that. So, now she says, Lakshanibhyo Dvijatibhyah, Lakshanibhyah, the people who study this Lakshana, the body features, etc., is something like say all the body formation and various features. So, all these those people, They have told me that this girl will have to go and stay in the forest. So, they have already told about me. Then, because of that, vanavasa krutotsaha, I have been enthusiastic, utsaha. So, that enthusiasm has built up in me over a period of time, because people have already pointed out this girl will go to forest, and I am with that enthusiasm. And she says, Prapyante niyatam vira purushair akrutatma vihi. All the problems which you are talking about are only for the feeble and weak-minded persons, and not for a person like you, not people who have that self-control and not people who have that courage. And she again quotes another woman, a bhikshini, some sort of female sadhu, bhikshini, some female sadhu. She came one day. And then she also, Kanyaya Piturgrehe Vanavasa Shrutomaya. So, one Bhishini came to her house, and she also had told about this girl going to forest, etc. Like we see various forest dwellers. For example, some of these tribes, the forest tribes, they come and then they just see our face and then they do some foretelling. For example, in Andhra area, we have got what is called a Koya tribe. They just come home and then they just observe your features. Okay, you have got two children, and then one son is, he will go abroad, another son will do this, that, etc. They will say something. So, they are very experts in reading. They are great experts in our mind reading, and then immediately capture our weaknesses, our family equation. They will find out whether what sort of relation you have with your wife, etc. They are very, very clever people, but at the same time not mischievous, but rather quite intelligent. So, anyway, she says, I have been nurturing all those thoughts, and I like living in a very, very wild manner, she says. Vanavasasya shurasya. So, this vanavasa, staying in the wild, shurasya, and staying with a valorous person like you, with a bold person like you, that is very, very fascinating, that's very attractive. So, I will do this forest dwelling as a sort of tapasya. And even after death, and she says, you see, a wife, even after death, she belongs to the husband only, she says. Of course, these are certain things, this is a value system which we had in those days. But now, of course, if you say the same value system, people will raise eyebrows. But anyway, she says, Pitruvirya Sriyasya Mahabala. So, you see, even after death, I belong to you only. then swadharmena pretyabhava epitasya. Pretyabhava. Pretyabhava means even after death. Then she says, so the wife has to bear the whether it is sukham or dukham, she has to bear it equally. Sama dukha sukha, she says, bhaktam pativratam dinam mam samam sukha dukha yoho saman. You see, the wife has to bear, she has to share the sukha or dukha of the husband without grudging, without complaining. And she finally, she says, I will die by poison or by fire. She says, visham agnim jalam va aham asthasye mrityukaranat. I'll take visham, that is poison, or I'll burn myself, or I will fall into water and end my life. And she begs like that, and they say, you do not have any fears because of me. I will not be a burden on you, etc., etc., she says. And that is how this particular, say, sarga comes to an end. And Rama, in spite of all that, Rama still tries to convince her, still tries to tell her, no, you stay back. Now we come to the next sarga, that is 30th sarga, where we see Sita almost rebelling. You see, Sita has told repeatedly, yes, no, there is no problem, I am going to come with you, and Rama is trying to convince her to stay back. Now Sita rebels, and then she says, you see, santvyamana tu ramena maithili janakatmaja. So while Rama continued to say, try to convince her, Janakatmaja, the word hints at the royal birth. She is, after all, she is also a royal lady, a very tough person, having a tough mind. And she says, pranayacha abhimanacha parichikshepa raghavam. Pranayacha abhimanacha. There are two things here. Pranaya is love and affection. Abhimana is self-respect. She is having love, but at the same time, she is also having self-respect. So, with these two things, she became sarosham. Sarosham means she became rather, not ferocious. Rosha is something like, when your self-respect is injured, you react in a very haughty manner. So, in a very haughty manner, she told, in a very harsh manner, she says, Kimtva manyata vaidehaha pitame mithiladhipaha. Rama jamataram prapya sriyam purusha vigraham. She says, you see, I just wonder how my father took you for a man. And he thought that you were a man. You are actually a woman in man's form, she says. You see, I just don't know why my father mistook you for a man. You are indeed a woman in a man's form. You see, when I am talking boldly, I will come along with you to the forest. You are talking in such a feeble way. You are talking like a woman. So, this is something which shows that Sita's determination, and at a particular time, she is saying in a very harsh manner also. And what is the cause of your fear? She says, Kim hi krutva vishannastvam kutova bhayamastite. Why are you so afraid? Why are you so scared? You see, it is wrong to say, again she says, she corrects herself and says, it is wrong to say that Rama is not valorous. There is some other reason. It is very, very incorrect if people say that Rama is not valorous. But there is some reason, something is there in your mind. You please tell me what is the reason. And she gives the examples of, some of these wives who followed, their husbands. In spite of various difficulties and all that, the wives, very meticulously followed the husbands. She gives the example of Savitri. Savitri and Satyavan. We know the story of Satyavan and Savitri. And of course, this is again in a very beautiful classic. It is portrayed by Aravinda also. Aravinda, he has portrayed it, Aravinda's Savitri, if you see. That of course, he has raised it to a highly philosophical level. But here of course, we are referring to a Puranic story where Satyavan, he was being taken by Yama, Lord Yama, to Yamaloka. And then this lady, Savitri, pursues, goes along with this Yama, and then he persuades Yama to give back this chap's life. So, like that, says Savitri, I will pursue you. And you see, I am not one who is going to bring any stigma on you, stigma on your family. Natvaham manasatvanyam drashtasmi. You see, even in my mind, I never thought of another person. Even in my mind, at any point of time, I never thought of any other person. And you are trying to leave me, and you are trying to ditch me. I have not brought any dishonor to your family, I have not brought any blemish to you. And you are behaving like this. We have lived together for such a long time. Swayam tu bharyam kaumarim chiram abhyushitam satim. See, I am a kaumari, means I am in youthful form. And chiram adhyushitam, for a long time we lived together. Immediately after marriage, for a few years they lived together. So for a few years we lived together. And you are trying to leave me. Shailusha ivamam rama parebhyodatu michasi. Again, she uses a very harsh word, Shailusha Iva. Shailusha is the people who belong to these drama troops. So, we in olden days, we used to see these drama troops, Nata, Nartaki. So, this Nata, whoever is this Nata or actor, say such people, they are supposed to be sharing their women also. Nata, Shailusha Iva, just like an actor, just like a Shailusha, you are trying to give me away to Bharata. You are telling me you go and you stay with, you be the nice with Bharata, you be nice to Bharata, don't criticize Bharata, etc., you have been saying. So she says, Shailusha Iva, just like an actor, you are going to pass me off to somebody else. How can you do that? You may have respect to your parents, you may want to obey your father's word and all that, but don't ask me to follow them. I have to follow you, that is my dharma. I am not here to follow your say parents. You may respect your parents, you may do whatever they bid, but then you should not dictate to me. And that is how she continues to say, and I am not going to give you any trouble. All the problems in the forest I will bear it, all the weather, if it is so harsh also, it will be like a bed of roses. Staying in the forest will be vihara shayaneshviva. It is as though we are going for a picnic. Vihara, vihara means going for a pleasure trip. Shayaneshviva, vihara shayaneshviva. It is like a bed of roses for me. I am going to stay like that. So, we will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.